This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com and Adrenal Fatigue Center. A lot of people ask me while they're on thyroid medication is why would their dosage need to be adjusted after a little while? In other words, many people do experience the necessity to especially increase their thyroid medication for their hypothyroidism after they've been started on the medication for some time. This can be 3 months, can be 6 months, can be a year, but over time they find that they need the ever larger dose of thyroid medication in order to achieve the similar effect that they had when they first started. This is a very interesting question, and it brings up the real underlying problem is that what is really going on in the thyroid gland. Now let's take a look at physiology here. If you have a primary hypothyroidism, that means something's wrong with the thyroid gland, is not making thyroid medication, then you give the body thyroid medication, you will feel brand new and you feel significantly better. This is indeed the case for many reasons. Whether you have primary or even secondary hypothyroidism, the fact that you put more thyroid medications into the body means that the body gets increased metabolism, and that leads to increase in energy, reduce in fatigue, reducing constipation, and there's a sense of well-being because it's almost like you're stepping on the gasoline pedal of the car and the car is running a little faster. So you're able to do more things during the day and less problematic. Now, as this goes on, most patients who are on thyroid after initial adjustment would be quite satisfied. But they would find that as time goes on, their fatigue tend to return. The constipation tend to get worse, and they go see the doctor. Laboratory tests are usually taken, and it could be normal, but they are feeling not as good. So the doctor will invariably raise the thyroid medication a little bit, and then a few months later, another little bit. Of course, if the thyroid test is showing that it's continuing to be low, then the doctor has more reasons to increase the dosage faster and stronger, and including adding other types of hormones, including testosterone and other types of growth hormone, etc. But just on the thyroid alone, if the thyroid testing does not show any significant change, but you still complain of being fatigued, then increasing thyroid dosage for you is quite common. The question is, why would that happen? And we have many reasons why to consider. First, there could be a resistance issue, meaning that the body is either getting used to it or it resists for the thyroid to actually get into the cell. There's also a problem of conversion. For example, when thyroid medications need to be converted into different parts in order to work in the cells, and if there is a defect in this conversion, then the body will not be able to get the thyroid that it needs. Number three, there could be also binding issues in the sense that thyroid medication could be bounded to certain proteins, such as thyroid binding globulins, and then when it is binded, it is not available to the cells. On top of that, the body could be getting used to it. There could be receptor site issues, or simply that the body deteriorate with time. So there are many, many factors that could cause this type of issue. The question is, how do you know which one is which? The laboratory test usually is not very good. It's not sensitive enough to really be able to tell us in great detail which part of the mechanism it may not be working well. So it really all comes down to detailed history, checking with your doctor on an ongoing basis, and asking the right questions. It is obvious that if you have to keep upping the dose, eventually some people will get into trouble. Symptoms such as wired and tired are quite frequent, and that is an indication that thyroid medication may have reached its maximum, and you have to question whether this is even the right thing to do at that point in time. There are many, many possibilities, and we cannot cover them all here. But the important thing to understand is that if it is not converting, or your body needs more, there's a reason. The reasons are many, including one which is often overlooked, which is adrenal fatigue. And so see your doctor, make sure you discuss these issues, and if there are no answers for you, then look outside the box and look into talking to a adrenal fatigue literate doctor for more explanation and to explore. The body reacts logically. If it is not working well, there is a reason. So I encourage you to pursue that as the way to understand the root problem, and the only by solving the root problem will you get to recover from your illness on a long-term basis. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.